Welcome to the Hindu News Analysis by Shankar IAS Academy for the date 31st May 2019. Displayed are the list of news articles selected for today's analysis and their page numbers in Chennai, Delhi, Bengaluru and Thiruvananthapuram editions of the newspaper. The link for the handwritten notes and the timestamping of the news articles are provided in the description box, and for the benefit of mobile phone viewers, the timestamping is also provided in the comment section. Now let us move on to the first news article. Now this article is relevant in prelims under rights issues in Indian polity and in mains in GS paper 2 in functioning of parliament and issues arising out of such functioning and government policies and interventions for development in various sectors and issues arising out of their design and implementation. See, the author talks about few controversial bills that were introduced by the previous government in the parliament. And with the dissolution of the Lok Sabha, these bills became no longer valid, or that these bills lapsed. But with the formation of the new government, now these aspects of the lapsed bills may be revived sooner or later. That is, they may soon reintroduce another bill on the same matter. So the author highlights the various controversies with respect to these lapsed bills. Now, some of the bills taken for today's editorial analysis by the author are a transgender bill, surrogacy bill and trafficking bill. And also finally, he talks about citizenship amendment bill as well. And first, this transgender bill, surrogacy bill and trafficking bill, the author states that these bills are the bills for the vulnerable sections in the society. And hence the title of the article. If you take the transgender bill, on one side, we have Supreme Court saying in NALSA judgment that it is for the individual to determine the gender identity. But the bill removed this fundamental and non-negotiable principle recognized by the Supreme Court and gave the determination of identity in the hands of government-appointed committees. The author is referring to district screening committees that are to be constituted by the government for the purpose of recognition of transgender persons, as it was proposed under Transgender Persons Protection of Rights Bill of 2018. Now, there were also issues in the provisions with respect to gender reassignment surgery as well. Now, if you come to surrogacy bill, now the issue is with the exclusion of sexual minorities who are homosexual individuals. That is, they cannot become parents by opting for surrogacy. Also, the bill imposed discriminatory age restrictions upon men and women when opting for a surrogate mother. And it also completely banned this commercial surrogacy. Commercial surrogacy is that when a couple gets a surrogate mother by paying a compensation. Now, surrogate mother is a woman who bears a child who is genetically related to the requesting couple through surrogacy, from the implantation of embryo in the womb of the surrogate mother. See, these are all author's personal opinions. The author feels that the commercial surrogacy should only be safeguarded from misuse and it actually should be allowed and regulated. The author feels that commercial surrogacy will happen, opening up space for underground exploitation of women with the potential to create a black market as well. Now that is, imagine government has banned commercial surrogacy. Now, if one pays for surrogate mother that is in violation with the law, then the money becomes illegitimate and it is illegitimate use of money or dirty money. And there are many more processes that will lead to this creation of black market. Now, the controversy with trafficking bill is that the criminalization of begging without providing any manner of effective alternatives. The bill also failed to differentiate non-consensual trafficking influenced sex work and consensual sex work. Now, this is a problematic area. See, some way women and men are into sex work even voluntarily. And several studies have found evidence that individuals take up sex work just at least to have food 3 times a day. When many individuals are in such situation in our country, and without creating alternative livelihood opportunities, it will be morally weak and unstable to criminalize those who take up the sex work on their own. That is what the author says. Now, with respect to transgender bill, the surrogacy bill and trafficking bill, some commonalities are observed by the author. First, see each of these bills deal with intimate subjects such as individuals' decisions of what to do with their body, about their personal dignity and autonomy, and also gender identity. Secondly, see these bills are associated with the rights of certain sections of the most vulnerable and marginalized members of our society. And these bills were drafted without having extensive and enough or adequate discussions with affected population or impacted communities. And rather than guaranteeing and securing the rights of these communities to be free from state interference, provisions of these bills extended the state's control and government's domination over these matters. And finally, we could see extensive and widespread protest were demonstrated by the very communities for whom the bill was proposed. Now, finally, the author comes to Citizenship Amendment Bill. Now, the bill aimed to provide citizenship to persecuted minorities from Pakistan, Afghanistan, and Bangladesh, to those persecuted minorities belonging to Hindus, Sikhs, Jainism, Buddhism, Parsiism, and Christians, but not Muslims. That is, if a Muslim comes from these countries, that is Pakistan, Afghanistan, and Bangladesh, because of facing persecution in these countries, he will not be given citizenship, but those people belonging to other religions will be given citizenship. Thus, the bill categorically eliminated the communities who face persecution in these countries among Muslims. If you take Pakistan, Muslims from the Ahmadiyyas and the Baloch communities are facing persecution. Therefore, this move, this citizenship amendment bill proposed by the previous government, the author calls as illogical, clearly discriminatory on the grounds of religion. Now, with respect to some of the party members, senior party members of the ruling party who propose a nationwide NRC exercise, the author says it is extremely sickening to ask the people of India to prove their citizenship. Now, the thought behind involving everyone in the country to undergo NRC update process is that everyone in the country is an illegal migrant. Then the nationwide NRC would become a nightmare of administration and implementation. We can observe this from the recent exercise of NRC update process in the state of Assam. NRC is nothing but National Register of Citizens, the register that consists of the names of Indian citizens. There is also emotional strain on people, as people from same family, for some their name updated in NRC, for other persons of the same family, their names are not added. The emotional strain has led people to take suicides in certain instances. Now, we were able to see overlapping functions between NRC machinery of the state of Assam and the Foreigners Tribunal. On one side, one say that a person is an illegal migrant. On the other say the same person may not be an illegal migrant. So there is difference of opinion even between the NRC machinery of the state government of Assam and the Foreigners Tribunal. And there is no question in our country that other than the state of Assam, there is a problem of illegal migrants. The author states that there is no credible evidence to demonstrate that there is large-scale illegal immigration taking place in India, and therefore a nationwide NRC is not required. And if such a NRC exercise is conducted all over India, then the process will lead to massive waste of resources, and this will also act as a gateway to trigger violence in our country. And as a conclusion, the author states that the government has to first listen to the voices of the people who will be directly impacted by the law or policy, and they have to be engaged in good faith and in all these processes, say from discussion to the drafting of the bill, till it becomes a law with president's assent, basic constitutional principles and values must be respected. And it is also to be hoped that some of the shortcomings in various aspects of the discussed bills could be remedied by the continuing government in power. And before introducing the bills in the same drafted format, the government should redraft these bills with participatory opinions from the affected people. In addition to the role of government and the courts, you know, to remove the problem stated in this discussion, it will require sustained public movement so as to make the voice of the voices of the impacted or affected people to be heard in the halls of power. Now, that is, halls of power in our context means parliament that enacts legislations. With this, we come to the end of this article discussion. See, the displayed practice mains question will be discussed in the practice cum revision session. Now, let us take up the analysis for next news article. Now, this news article is about cloud seeding. It states that Hindustan Aeronautics Limited and IIT Kanpur has offered low-cost cloud seeding options to the Karnataka government. Now, this article will be relevant in prelims under current events of national importance and physical geography, and also in general science. The state cabinet of Karnataka government has approved a budget of 91 crore for cloud seeding for next 2 years. Now, let's see about cloud seeding. See, generally, how rainfall happens. See, there are super cool droplets of water present in the clouds. They are still in liquid form, but when they are at a temperature below the usual freezing point of 0 degrees centigrade, they form ice crystals. When these ice crystals become too heavy to remain suspended in air, they start to fall down to earth. On their way, they melt down to form or give rain. Now, this is a simple description, but there are also complex processes associated with rainfall. Now, even in dry areas, the air usually contains some moisture or water. Now, this can be made to come together to form ice crystals by seeding the atmosphere or seeding the clouds with chemicals such as silver iodide, potassium iodide, or dry ice. Now, these chemicals help in giving rainfall by inducing nucleation. Now, nucleation means whatever little water that is present in the dry air condenses around the newly introduced particles, and these crystallizes to form ice. So, these chemicals are called as seeds. So, there are two ways of delivering these seeds in the atmosphere. One is through plane, and next one is done by spraying from the ground. This seeding process is called as cloud seeding. So, with respect to first method, see cloud seeding by plane. Now, if you see this picture, a radar is required. The radar will identify the moisture-bearing clouds within its coverage area or within its vicinity. The identification range depends on the type of radar that is being used. The meteorologists check for certain conditions before they induce this artificial rain. See, they will check whether there are clouds with enough moisture to induce artificial rain. They will also check about convectional movement of air and also lower wind velocity or the wind speed so that maximum rain can be achieved on cloud seeding. If the conditions are positive for creating artificial rain, the aircraft or the plane with the seeding chemicals such as silver iodide or dry ice, it takes off and it sprays them on the clouds. Now, this is called as seeding or dispersion. And within some 15 to 20 minutes, one can see the rainfall happening in the area. The second method of cloud seeding is done by spraying the chemicals from the ground level. Here, a little amount of silver iodide is sprayed along with propane flame, and the silver iodide particles rise into the clouds and help in forming rain. So, cloud seeding is basically a type of weather modification. So, when there is some question with respect to weather modification by inducing chemicals or man-made or anthropogenic weather modification, you can talk about cloud seeding. Now, in this news article, it has been mentioned that two companies from United States has responded to the global tender called by the state government of Karnataka. And these companies focused on importing radars, planes, pilots from companies in United States alone. So, all those things have to come from US to India. So, the costs will definitely become very high, and also the import procedures will add to further delays. And the Karnataka state government is expecting to start this process of cloud seeding by the end of June, and probably will continue for next 3 months, even during the monsoon season. Now, the main news is that Hindustan Aeronautics Limited and Indian Institute of Technology Kanpur, they have offered low-cost indigenous technology to enhance this rainfall or this artificial rain. Now the offer is based on salts which act like dispersing seeding agents, and these salts are developed indigenously by IIT Kanpur. And the news article has no mention whether these salts are whatever we discussed so far, silver iodide or potassium iodide or dry ice, or whether it is a new discovery or any other new chemical, we don't know. And IIT Kanpur has partnered with this Hindustan Aeronautics Limited. The HAL will provide aircraft and trained pilot support for the cloud seeding. Chemical support will be given by IIT Kanpur. The deputy director of IIT Kanpur has said these salts have proven to be more effective in catalyzing this rainfall. And you should note that cloud seeding was done in Karnataka in 2017. That has resulted in 28% additional rainfall. And therefore, Karnataka government has decided to continue the same thing even this year, that is cloud seeding. With this, we come to the end of this article discussion. The displayed prelims question will be discussed in the last session. With this, let's move on to next news article. Now, the next news article is about pending recommendations of the Election Commission since the year 2015. That is, since the conduct of elections for 16th Lok Sabha. Now, the news article will be helpful in mains preparation under GS Paper 2 in functions and responsibilities of various constitutional bodies, and also in salient features of Representation of People Act. Some 9 working groups were set up by Election Commission of India to suggest improvements in specific areas based on their experience during 2014 Lok Sabha elections. Around some 337 recommendations were submitted. Out of this 337 recommendations, some 300 recommendations have been disposed of so far by the government. That is, some action, either acceptance or rejection, may have been taken on these 300 recommendations, but some 37 recommendations are still pending since the year 2014 before the government. Now, one among the suggestions was drafting legal provisions to disqualify candidates for offenses that start with 5 years imprisonment, and this disqualification has to be carried out in a earlier stage of the entire criminal justice system. That is, on framing of charges, that is immediately after the submission of final report or charge sheet, rather than disqualifying them after the conviction by the court, because sometimes conviction takes several years. Now, when we talk about charge sheet, see, this charge sheet or final report is submitted after the investigation of police officer related to a particular case. When an FIR is registered, immediately police will arrest the accused and those process will carry on. Immediately after filing of FIR, within some reasonable time frame, police has to complete the investigation and submit the charge sheet. Now, the Election Commission is recommending to disqualify a person, you know, immediately after filing the charge sheet, if the particular offences has a minimum punishment of 5 year imprisonment. Now, the punishment for filing false affidavits are asked to increase from 6 months to more than 2 years. An affidavit is nothing but a written statement that is confirmed by an oath or affirmation that has to be submitted by a contesting person or an individual, you know, while contesting in the elections. Another recommendation is that candidates who are found guilty of corruption and heinous crimes, you know, they must be permanently disqualified from contesting in elections. This is one another recommendation. And a working group has suggested some amendments in empowering the Election Commission to issue notice to a political party for necessary corrections in the manifesto of a political party. Now, the Election Commission has also recommended for the setting up of courts to adjudicate electoral offences, and in order to reduce the duration of election process. Alright, and the associated problems with respect to each localities. The Election Commission has asked to consider the various factors such as weather, examination schedules, festivals with respect to every state for scheduling of polls. And next, with respect to political party, the recommendation is that the number of members required for a political party registration should be increased from 100 to 1000. And they are also asking those political parties that do not field any candidate in elections has to be deregistered. And one another matter is with respect to funding of political parties. We have been seeing a lot of news related to political funding, particularly funding for political parties, and also the issues of transparency and related to that.
One recommendation with respect to that is there has to be specific legal provisions, you know, to regulate funding of political parties. They are actually asking for a comprehensive bill to deal with registration, recognition, and funding of political parties that has to be drafted. And then in an attempt to prevent some malpractices that happen during elections, because we see some identity card numbers of voter ID card. In some states, there are 10 digits. In some states, there are 16 digits. So they are asking for standardization of voter photo identity card numbers. And for speedy resolution of expenditure-related matters during elections, they are requesting for a setting up of fast track courts. Now, if you see, there will be series of questions with respect to who will be punished with respect to seizure of various money from various places during the conduct of elections. Election Commission state more than 1,000 crore has been received during the conduct of 17th Lok Sabha. More than 3,000 crore has been received during the conduct of recent Lok Sabha elections. Now, there will be questions among the people who will be punishing them, how long it will take to punish these people who transferred money from one locality to other locality for distribution of these money. So, the Election Commission recommends setting up a fast track courts for speedy resolution of this expenditure related matters during the elections. With this, let's move on to our next news article. Now, this news article talks about World Health Organization giving award to Rajasthan Health Department. Now, the discussion will be relevant in prelims under current events of national and international importance and in general science. Will also be helpful in main syllabus in GS paper 2 in area of functioning of ministries and departments of the government and in government interventions for development in various sectors. Next in issues relating to development and management of social sector relating to health. The discussion can also be linked to environmental pollution and degradation in GS paper 3. Now, World Health Organization has selected Medical and Health Department of Rajasthan State Government for an award this year. See, this award is in recognition of the department's achievement in the field of tobacco control. The Medical and Health Department has launched several campaigns against this tobacco consumption in the last financial year, that is 2018-19. These campaigns were organized at schools, colleges, police stations and several government offices. Now, this award will be given to the Rajasthan state government, particularly this department, at a function in New Delhi for marking this World No Tobacco Day, and which it is expected, as it is stated, that the department's particular department's additional chief secretary will receive the award. See, the health department of the state is the only government body in the country which will be awarded for its tobacco free initiatives. Every year, this World Health Organization recognizes individuals or organizations in each of the six WHO regions for their successful accomplishments in the area of tobacco control. Now, this year, WHO has selected five organizations from the South Asian region alone for this prestigious award. See, three organizations were from Thailand and Indonesia. Two organizations out of these five organizations are from India. One is the Vallabhbhai Patel Chest Institute situated at New Delhi. Other is the Medical and Health Department of Rajasthan State Government. Now let us see about this World No Tobacco Day. See, today, May 31, every year is celebrated as World No Tobacco Day. The WHO and its global partners celebrate World No Tobacco Day on every year in May 31. It is an annual campaign where there will be an opportunity to raise awareness on the harmful and deadly effects of tobacco use. Not only about this tobacco use, but also the harmful and deadly effects of secondhand smoke exposure, and also to discourage the use of tobacco in any form. See, the normal way how smoking hurts the non-smokers is through secondhand smoke. Now, you don't think secondhand smoke is using the puff of a smoking person. See, it's a combination of smoke that comes from a cigarette and smoke breathed out by a smoker. See, when a non-smoker is around someone who is smoking, they breathe in the secondhand smoke. Now, the secondhand smoke is dangerous because it consists of the smoke that comes from a cigarette and the smoke that is breathed out by a smoker. It is dangerous to anyone who breathes it in because it can stay in the air for several hours after somebody smokes and because of the harmful effects it can cause. Now, breathing secondhand smoke for even a short time can cause health effects to your body. Some health effects of secondhand smoke includes even lung cancer in people who have never smoked. Then it is more likely that someone will get a heart disease and even have a heart attack and die early. And the non-smokers who happens to smoke this secondhand smoke may also suffer from breathing problems like coughing, extra phlegm, wheezing and shortness of breath. The focus and theme for World No Tobacco Day 2019 is tobacco and lung health, and it has been planned or decided to increase awareness on the negative impact that this tobacco has on people's lung health, from cancer to chronic respiratory disease. And they have also planned to create awareness about the fundamental role lungs play for the health and well-being of all people. The campaign also advocates for effective policies to reduce tobacco consumption and also engaging stakeholders across multiple sectors in the fight of tobacco control. Now, what is tobacco? See, tobacco is a plant grown for its leaves. These leaves are dried and fermented before being put in tobacco products. See, tobacco contains nicotine, which is an ingredient that can lead to addiction. That is why many people who use tobacco find it very difficult to quit. And there are also many other potentially harmful chemicals found in tobacco, and these chemicals are also created by burning the tobacco also. People can smoke, chew and sniff tobacco. Smoked tobacco products include cigarettes, cigars, bidis and etc. Now, one of the main risk factors for a number of chronic diseases, including cancer, lung diseases and cardiovascular diseases, is tobacco use. Even though it is known that it is one of the main risk factors for a number of chronic diseases, it is still the tobacco use is common throughout the world. A number of countries have legislation restricting tobacco advertising and regulating who can buy and who can use tobacco products and where people can smoke. You must know how tobacco endangers the lung health of the people. Now let's talk about lung cancer. See, tobacco smoking is the primary cause of lung cancer. It is responsible for more than 66% of lung cancer deaths globally. And secondhand smoke exposure at home or in the workplace also increases the risk of lung cancer. And how to reduce the risk of lung cancer for a smoking person is just a simple quitting smoking. And now, chronic respiratory disease. And they say tobacco smoking is the leading cause of chronic obstructive pulmonary disease. Now, this is a condition where buildup of pus-filled mucus in the lungs that results in a painful cough and severe unbearable breathing difficulties. And it is also stated that the risk of developing this chronic obstructive pulmonary disease is high among individuals who start smoking at a young age. Because when they start smoking at a young age, this tobacco smoke significantly slows down the development of lungs. See, tobacco also aggravates asthma and tuberculosis. Now, this restricts the activity of lungs and contributes even to disability. It has ability to disable a person. Tuberculosis generally damages the lungs and reduces lung function. And this is now aggravated by tobacco smoke. Infants who are exposed to tobacco smoke toxins in utero frequently experience reduced lung growth and function. Now, exposure to tobacco smoke toxins in utero, that is while in the womb of the mother, that's what we say, in utero. So infants, when they are exposed to tobacco smoke, they frequently experience reduced lung growth and function. And this could be because of maternal smoking, that is smoking by mother, or maternal exposure to secondhand smoke. Now, young children exposed to secondhand smoke are at risk of onset and aggravation of asthma, pneumonia, bronchitis, and frequent lower respiratory infections as well. Now, one should note that around 60,000 children in the world die before the age of 5 because of lower respiratory infections that is caused by secondhand smoke. Now, that is the problem created by smokers. While discussing the syllabus, we saw that this analysis will also can also be linked to environmental pollution. See, tobacco smoke is a very dangerous form of indoor air pollution. Now, this is because it contains over 7,000 chemicals, and know that 69 of them are known to cause cancer, carcinogenic. Though smoke may be invisible and odorless, it can linger in the air for up to 5 hours. It can stay in the air for up to 5 hours. This puts everyone who's exposed to the smoke at risk of lung cancer, chronic respiratory diseases, and reduced lung function. Now, we have a sustainable development goal target. That is target number 3.4. If you read it along with three small letter A, which is given in the SDG goal book, it says for 1/3 reduction in premature or earlier mortality from non-communicable diseases by 2030. And therefore, it aspires that tobacco control must be a priority for governments and communities worldwide. This is also recognized by World Health Organization. Currently, if you see the trend, the World Health Organization says the world is not on track to meeting this target. And it's our duty to provide a healthy environment to the next generation and also to next person. And it would be also even beneficial if you take a pledge not to smoke. With this, we come to the end of this article discussion. The displayed prelims question will be discussed in the last session. Now let us move on to next news article. Now this news article is about Global Childhood Report. The content will be relevant in prelims under current events of national and international importance, and in mains in GS paper 2 under vulnerable sections, that is welfare schemes for vulnerable sections of the population by the center and states, and mechanisms for the protection and betterment of these vulnerable sections. The discussion may also be helpful for your essay writing as well. Now, this Global Childhood Report discusses the overall conditions of the children prevailing at a global level at present. The report has noted that children of today are better off than those 20 years ago. And that's the title of the news article. Now, if you see the Global Childhood Report is released by Save the Children. Now, Save the Children is a United States-based non-government organization that is working for the education and protection of child rights. Now, they have many offices in various countries, also in our country as well. Now, coming to the outcomes of the Global Childhood Report 2019, the report states that the overall situation of childhood has improved in almost more number of countries. To be accurate, see 173 of 176 countries since the year 2000. Now, the children who are born today, they have better chance than the children at any time in history. The report tells that the children at present receive proper and right support to grow up healthy, you know, get education and protection, and they also have the opportunity to reach their full potential. Now, if you see the condition of children, children before one generation, the report states that a child born a generation before was twice as likely to die before reaching the age 5 than the children at present. Now, 70% of the children born a generation before are more likely to be involved in child labor when compared to the present generation. And the children born a generation ago are 20% more likely to be murdered when compared to this generation. And in 2000, nearly 97 crore children were denied their childhood due to reasons such as ill health, malnutrition, exclusion from education, child labor, child marriage, early pregnancy, and violent death. But globally, this number has now reduced to 69 crore at present. Now, if you see the difference, you could understand that at least 28 crore children are better off today than the children before 20 years. Now, this non-government organization, Save the Children, also releases an index named as End of Childhood Index. Almost 176 countries have been considered for this index. The index notes that the overall situation of children has improved in 173 of 176 countries since the year 2000. And one special thing is that in some of the poorest countries, we could see huge progress in this. Now, this is a clear evidence that development work is giving huge advantage for these poorest countries so as to focus more on their social sector development. Except one area, the index notes that almost all areas there have been significant progress for children since the year 2000. First, if you take, say, there is 49% drop in the under 5 child death rate, under 5 child mortality rate when compared to 2000 levels, and 40% drop in child labor, 33% drop in chronic malnutrition or stunting, and around 33% drop in out of school children has been recorded if you compare it with 2000 levels, and 25% drop in child marriage has also been seen. Now see these child marriage, out of school children facing chronic malnutrition, child labor, under 5 child mortality rate. These are some of the issues with respect to children rather than the numbers of decrease. You kindly keep it in mind. All these are some of the problems existing in the children's sector. There is also a 22% drop in adolescent pregnancy when compared to 2000 levels. See, as per National Youth Policy of India, if you see an individual in the age group of age 13 to 19 year is an adolescent. So the pregnancy during this adolescent age is called as adolescent pregnancy. According to WHO, which defines adolescents as individuals in the 10 to 19 years age group. So generally, if you see, an adolescent will be most probably in the age of teenage population from the year 13 to 19. It includes, although we see some differences between organization in defining this adolescence. And in India, legally, a child is defined as a person who has not completed 18 years of age. And a 17% drop can be seen in child homicides comparing to 2000 levels. See, homicide means killing or murdering. Sometime even means suicide. Here, the murderer is the one's own self. Now, the report tells that at least 85,000 boys and girls under the age of 20 were murdered in the year 2016 alone. And about 40% of these victims were under 15 years of age. So in the year 2000, it was 97,000 child homicides. So this is, there is a difference of 12,000 less comparing to the year 2000. And this translates into a 17% decrease in the child homicide rate globally. Now, what is the importance of this child homicide is that each of these deaths represent more and more children living in violent or abusive environments. So both these conditions, particularly adolescence pregnancy and child homicides, we can see some moderate improvement only. Now, we have seen some data. We observed that there is a significant or moderate improvement in almost all the conditions. But if you closely observe the index notes that there has been no progress at all in reducing the number of children living in areas of violence and conflict, or the areas that are war-torn. Now, the conditions of children suffering due to conflict have become worse when compared to 2000 levels. Now, the area of violence is harmful for children because children will be forced to flee from their own homes during such a conflict. Now, if you look at the number of children living in war zones and who are forced to flee their homes due to a conflict, this has increased since the year 2000. The report talks about stolen childhoods, and it states that the stolen childhoods are increasingly concentrated in the world's conflict zones. Now, we know that childhood is the right time that is considered safe for growing, learning and playing. See, if a child is denied this right due to any reasons like conflict or war, then it is called as a, or any other reasons for that matter, then it is called as stolen childhood. Also, children make up about 30% of the world's population, but more than half of the world's refugees are children. Now, let's come to India-specific data. See, India's rank in this end of childhood index for the year 2019 is 113. In 2018 also, it was 113. In 2017, it was 116. So there was a marginal improvement in the year, and now almost the same status in the year 2018 with reference to 2018. The education rates among women and girls have increased in India, and this has led to improvements in child health and protection in our country. The report has appreciated the efforts taken in our country to end the child marriages. Now, India has achieved 57% reduction in child mortality. Now, that is a significant reduction in child mortality comparing to 2000 levels. Now, the number of Indian children dying after the first month and before the age of 5 has fallen by 70% since 2000. That is from 13 lakhs to 3,84,000. But the number of newborn deaths or the neonatal mortality rate has declined by only 52% when compared to 2000 levels. See, neonatal mortality rate is what they say when the children die after the during the first month after birth. Stunted children have reduced to just 230 lakhs at present. Now, this is a 30% reduction when compared to 2000 levels. Now, if you exclude household domestic work, child labor among 5-year-old to 14-year-old children in India has seen a 70% reduction in comparison with 2000 levels. Now, child marriage is reduced 51% since 2000 and 63% since 1990. India has greatly reduced child marriage, particularly through legal reforms and programs to educate and empower girls and women and through public awareness campaigns. Next, coming to adolescent pregnancy, India has cut teen births by 63% since 2000 and 75% since 1990. This has reduced by almost 20 lakh teen births in India comparing to the year 2000. In 2000, it was 35 lakhs and now it is 14 lakhs. Now, this means that the progress in India alone accounts for nearly 3/4 of the global reduction in adolescent births during this period. So, at the end of the day, the report says overall conditions of the children have significantly improved globally from what it was in the year 2000. You know, only area where there was no progress or has gone worse is the children who are suffering due to war or conflict or violence. And India also has seen a remarkable improvement because of the policies, programs, education, awareness creation, etc. You can use these statistics in your mains questions related to child policy, children, child marriages or child mortality or child malnutrition or any other matters that we have discussed with respect to children in this report. Now, the displayed practice prelims question will be discussed in the last session. The practice cum revision session. Now, the first question, cloud seeding. The question is with respect to cloud seeding. Cloud seeding is an artificial way of inducing moisture in the cloud so as to cause the rainfall. Now, they are asking which of the below mentioned chemicals are used in cloud seeding process. Now, if you observe here, one of the chemical is given as sulfuric acid. Now, you would have heard the concept of acid rain. See, one of the components of acid rain is sulfuric acid. The acid rain is very detrimental and harmful and fatal to the entire environment, to plants, animals and humans. So how will one use sulfuric acid to, you know, induce moisture in clouds? So you can logically eliminate sulfuric acid. So any option that has the statement 3 should not be an answer for this question. So if you do that, option A, option B, option D gets eliminated. Option C is the correct answer. Now, we saw in our discussion that the chemicals that are used in cloud seeding include silver iodide, potassium iodide and dry ice. So, here we have the second silver iodide and fifth dry ice. So, option C is correct. Now, the second question is with respect to tobacco control. They have given two statements and are asking which of the statements are correct. The first statement states, May 31 is celebrated as World No Tobacco Day by the World Health Organization. Now, this statement is correct. Because today, every year, May 31 is celebrated as World No Tobacco Day by the WHO to create awareness about not using, about the problems of tobacco and also to reduce and to eliminate tobacco consumption. The second statement says WHO conferred a prestigious award in 2019 to the Medical and Health Department of the Karnataka government for achievements in the field of tobacco. Now, this statement is also wrong because the prestigious award was given to Rajasthan government. See, whenever you see some appreciation of a initiative taken by a particular government, when some awards are given, when some initiatives are recognized at the global level, see, this Rajasthan government's medical and health department was conferred this prestigious award by WHO because of its achievement in tobacco control. Now, this recognition was It was one of the five institutes, one of the five organizations in Southeast Asian region of WHO being conferred by this award. One another institute from India is Vallabhbhai Patel Chest Institute. Now, whenever you write answers for mains exam, whenever you have to cite some best practices, you can cite these efforts as an example. So, both the statements, so first statement is correct and the second statement is wrong. If somewhere the second statement had the word of Rajasthan government, the second statement would have been correct. So, the answer for this question is option A, one only. Now, this statement is with respect to the report released by Save the Children, a non-governmental organization. Now, they are asking, end of childhood index is released by which of the following? Last year, if you see the question paper, they would have been asked about the rule of law index, which was released by World Justice Project. But this time, this question is about end of childhood index. So, we studied that this index is released by the non-governmental organization called as Save the Children, that is working for education and protection of child rights. Now, UNICEF releases a report by the name of State of the World's Children, State of the World's Children Report. And SIPRI, which is Stockholm International Peace Research Institute, is an international institute, independent institute, which is dedicated to research into conflict, armaments, arms control and disarmament. So, the correct answer for this question is option B, Save the Children. Now, there is one practice question, mains practice question, GS paper 2. Some of the bills lapsed with the dissolution of 16th Lok Sabha are with respect to rights of the vulnerable sections of the population and are mired with controversies. What exactly are the issues in these bills and suggest the commonalities observed in these bills? Now, 16th Lok Sabha is 2014 to 2019. Now, the newly elected Lok Sabha is 17th Lok Sabha. Now, for this question, you can take your answer writing based on today's editorial analysis. You may state that some of the bills that are lapsed are transgender bill, surrogacy bill and trafficking bill. Shortly say that the impacted people are the vulnerable sections of the society. For example, in the case of transgender bill, you may say that the affected are the transgender community in terms of gender minorities. In terms of surrogacy, you may say that it affects the rights of sexual minorities in opting for children through surrogacy. In trafficking bill, you may say that it affects those who do consensual sex work voluntarily without having the opportunity to take any viable alternative livelihood activities. These are affected. These are the people who are affected by these bills. Now, then you add the problems in these bills as we have discussed in the analysis today. Now, with respect to the commonalities in the decision-making process, we may say that any bill that has to be drafted must have a wider consultation with the affected parties. All three bills fall short in this regard. And rights of individuals' decision and the influence of the state control and domination in each of the matter is one another commonality. And vulnerable and the marginalized sections have conducted extensive and widespread protest. And with respect to all these three bills, extensive and widespread protests were demonstrated by various communities for whom the very bill was proposed. And you can add your own views in the making of answer to this question. With this, we come to the end of today's The Hindu News Analysis. If you like the video, press the like button, share, comment and subscribe to Shankar IAS Academy YouTube channel for daily updates on The Hindu News Analysis.